and welcome to Magic Labs. My name is Whisperfire, and we just got back from our little field trip to get these tainted soil blocks. Basically, we went way out, about 2,000 blocks somewhere, and played with some taint and did a little bit of a time lapse. And along the way, we unlocked two new pieces of research. We unlocked the taint seed and the tentacle. So let's go ahead, take this moment and review over these two new pieces of research, and then we'll continue in our study in alchemy. So, tentacle. These dangerous growths look like giant tentacles. They will lash out at anything that comes nearby. Thought they were immobile, keeping your distance may not be... Thought they were immobile, keeping your distance might not keep you as safe, as miniature versions of them will spawn all around you should you draw their attention. Ooh. Okay, so let's go ahead and look at taint seed. Occasionally, tight knots of tainted tendrils will form. From out of this seed, foul tainted air will spew, which acts as the basis for the new taint growth. These seeds can lash out to defend themselves, but the risk must be taken if you wish to rid an area of taint. Without these foul air these seeds create, tainted growth soon withers and dies. If you notice, the moment we killed the tentacle, some of the blocks actually started to despawn and revert back to normal. So, of all of the tainted blocks that we got all of these stacks plus some taint wood logs. So, let's go ahead and check up on what we need to do. And while we're at it, while we're on this page, let's unlock Golemancy for later. So let's go ahead and just take care of it and get it done out of the way. Okay, so this will make a new tab for Golemancy. This book has taught me many things: how to manipulate matter and magic on a fundamental level, how to imbue objects with magical properties, and even how to draw magic from the very air around me. Still, some things elude me. There are some very basic but amazingly magical things almost anyone can do. Just stacking a few blocks together in the right pattern will cause them to transform into semi-sentient animated golems. How is this possible? Why would it even happen? Is the aura somehow responsible for this? I should study this phenomenon more closely. So we got observation golemancy, observation fundamentals, and we need to study an animated construct, which means either a snow or an iron golem. Snow is easier, so let's go ahead and grab some snow. So we'll just make a snow golem real quick just to unlock it. All right, and we're gonna just put him outside because eventually it will rain and he will disappear and die. So I'm not too worried about it. So let's just put it right here and bam, bam. And we scan him. There we go. Okay, that should take care of it. So, complete. My findings are confusing to say the least. The natural golems can be created and are indeed infused with viz, but I do not believe their creation is thaumaturgical in nature. Whatever force animates them seems to come from elsewhere. Still, my research has at least borne some fruit. I have studied this animating force and I believe I can recreate it using thaumaturgical principles. I should further my studies as soon as possible. And guess what? Now we got a Golemancy tab. And to start with basic Golemancy. I now understand the basic concepts that shape Golemancy, but I am sure I can improve on the primitive constructs that anyone can craft. At least, at the very least, I can use arcane science to design a simple mind that will be both dependable and predictable, instead of relying on the chaotic nature of magic to direct my constructs. So, we got a new line of research to do, and then to pick up where we left off, we were looking at Essentia tubes, and we needed the file of vitium, which is why we needed to do the taint research in the first place. And then viniculum, alienus, and alchema. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. Ooh, the moon. Okay, we got that. And up, 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 up. That should be, yeah, we, let's see, can we get the moon? Come on. You gotta get the moon in clear sight. I'm trying to get the phases of the moon, and it's kind of difficult. Not quite reliable. But, heck with it. Heck with it. We got a nice collection of celestial observations. So we'll just put that away for now. Okay, so let's see. We'll just go ahead and get into the void jars. So let's go ahead and grab a couple of these. Yeah, 10 for now, and grab some labels. All right, and we'll just grab some of these labels. Okay, now I have already pre-filled the Essentia Smeltery with alumentum. And let's take a look at the tainted soil. We need 10 of the viniculum. So we're just gonna need to do two of these for now. So let's hope that none of it gets lost. Okay. Let's hope that none of it gets lost in their, oh, we got a little bit of flux. Let's see, hold down shift. We got 12 flux in the area. And it looks like 20% of it was lost. So let's go ahead, pop in one more. Trying to be a little frugal with it. We need 10 viniculum. And it looks like we are going to need some more of that. All right, let's try two more. All right, come on, we need 10. Okay, so let's go ahead and grab our jar and grab our jar, and we will pop these over here. So, Nictium, Terra, is there anything else? Nope, okay. Now let's take these labels. We have to put the labels after we put in an Essentia, because it kind of acts like a filter. So we got 10 of that. And let's see, what else did we need? Let's see, viniculum. All right, let's go ahead and look up JEI for viniculum. Viniculum is the trap. So that would be the trap door. Okay, so trap, and we needed, all right, let's just grab three of these for good measure. Okay, pop that in there. That should give us 10 at least. So we'll let that go. And that lost 20%. Okay, so we'll go ahead and take our jar and take our label, and we will start filling up this wall full of Essentia jars. Okay, now what else was needed? We needed alienus. Alienus, I think, would be ender pearls, right? Alienus is a good source from ender pearls, right? Yeah, ender pearls. Okay, I already got an ender pearl. So let's go ahead and grab two of these. That should do it. Pop these two in there. And we should get some alienus. All right. Now, what is the last one? Alchema. Okay, alchema is bit interesting. It's one of the new aspects that came with Thaumcraft 6. So, alchema, would be, brewing stands. Huh. Brewing stands. I think we have a blaze rod, don't we? Yeah, we can make brewing stands. That's a good idea. Okay, so we'll go ahead and get that. And we will pick up the alienness and place you over here with a label. Oh, wrong jar. Bam. And with you with a label. Okay, and let's make a brewing stand. Okay, so let's scan it. Okay. And let's see. Alchema. All right, we'll put that in there. And how much does this get? Ooh, just one will be enough. Okay, so this is a big thing. So we'll just pop that in there and let that cook through the alembics. And we got some instrumentum, I think. Or was that Fabrico? Not sure. And Modus and Alchemia. Okay, so we'll grab that. And we'll grab that. And we'll let the Alchemia accumulate. Got a little bit of Ignis. And some Potentia. Alright, is there anything left? There's some left. So, grab the Alchemia. And this, and this. Oh, we're gonna need some more jars. All right, and take that. Actually, that is a duplicate. So we'll need to figure out how to transfer to those two. And that, and that, and that, and that. And label, 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 label. Label, label. And we got a little bit, we got one more. Okay, so get another jar and another label. Okay, come on. I love these jars. These jars are awesome. All right, and we'll place you over there and place that. Now we need some files. And we need four of them. Okay, so we need one alienness, one alchema, one verniculum. Now, where's the trap? Looks like we got another duplicate. Okay. We got it through the trap door, right? Cobweb. Okay, let's see about getting a cobweb. All right, and that has two. All right, so we'll grab three of these. And we'll just pop that in there. We're gonna need another jar. Gonna need three of these, I believe. And let's see. Take that, take that, and labels. Okay. Now, we got a duplicate here and here. So I will have to figure out what to do with it. That is Mutus. So that was with the trap door. So I derped. And that, okay. So, let's see. That is the viniculum. That is the trap that we were looking for. And that is empty. Okay. And not quite what I had in mind. All right, so how do I All right, did I get my label back? I don't think so. Okay, so we got, anyway, we got the Essentia that we need. So we'll just place them here. And let's see. This, and we got everything. So, it says, I can transport Essentia around in jars or in flasks, and it's not as useful on large-scale alchemical operations. The obvious answer is to transport Essentia with pipes or tubes, but due to volatile nature, no mundane pipe will be able to transport it. I should gather some exotic Essentia samples and use them to test various materials. Essentia tubes. I have unlocked the key to creating stable and relatively leak-free tubing. While mundane chemicals can be transported in glass, certain types of Essentia either dissolve or simply pass right through it. By wrapping the glass in iron and treating it with quicksilver, I've managed to protect it from even the most volatile types of Essentia. Brass fittings finish off the piping system, making it visually appealing. The tubes can be connected to all manner of alchemical devices through warded jars, and alembics are their primary targets. Essentia flows through tubes whenever something is connected to it that can accept it, like warded jars. Jars containing different kinds of Essentia will only draw their kind of Essentia towards them. Tubes can only draw and transport one kind of Essentia at a time. The highest drawing strength will take priority. Without the proper use of valves, it is quite easy for a network of tubes to get gummed up. The use of valves is essential. When you see gases being vented from the tube, it means different kinds of suction are interfering with each other. The color gives a clue as to what types of suction is causing the problem. Tubes can be connected and disconnected from their neighbors by clicking on a section of tubing with a caster. A caster can be used to click on the central section to rotate certain tubes like the valve. So let's take a look. We got an Essentia resonator. It's kind of like a tuning fork. And then we got the Essentia tube, the Essentia valve, the filtered Essentia tube, the restricted Essentia tube, the directional Essentia tube, the Essentia buffer, and the alchemical construct. That is something we need to get into, is the alchemical construct. So let's see, what did it unlock? Okay, we need to do improved Essentia distillation because I want to unlock this. So let's take a look. While Essentia smelters can be very fast, they can always be faster, especially at the speed of which they break down the Essentia slurry into usable Essentia. It should be a simple matter for me to speed up this process. And we got Observation Alchemy and Artifice. Alright, I have discovered a way to make Essentia smelting faster and more efficient, the auxiliary slurry pumps. Each auxiliary slurry pump placed on the side of a smelter acts as a secondary processor, outputting refined Essentia to any alembic placed above it. So we need to get this pump. So we need arcane bellows, an alchemical construct. So we need to do some more crafting, but can we do the improved Essentia distillation part 2? Designing the slurry pumps have given me an idea to reduce the amount of flux generated during the smelting process. I should follow up on these ideas as soon as possible. Okay, so let's complete the research. I have discovered a way to manage the flux generated by the smelting process by running the slurry through a secondary set of venting ports. Fitted with filters, I'm able to separate out the flux and safely vent it out as harmless steam. Like the slurry pumps, the vents need to be placed on the sides of the smelter. This process will reduce flux by about a third, and additional vents will increase this, though there are diminishing returns. So the auxiliary venting ports. So we need to make an alchemical construct. That's been bringing us back to here. So we need to make two Essentia valves. That would be four Essentia tubes. So let's go ahead and take a look. We need some brass. So we'll just grab two of these because we need to make it into, we need to make it into nuggets. Then some quicksilver. We just need some droplets. I'll just grab 10 of these. And we needed some iron. And we needed about, we'll just grab a bunch of these. Okay, and then we need some great wood. We need some great wood planks. And we need some levers. Okay. And we don't have any. Okay. Cobble. Stick. Okay. Get back here. Okay, so let's make ourselves a lever. All right, and teach the system levers. Okay. And we'll grab another. And we'll convert this to nugs. And also teach it nuggets. Okay, so let's see. We are going to need this table. And we are going to need some viz pipes. Yeah. Okay, so let's go ahead and look up our Thaumonomicon. And to make the Essentia tube, we need glass. Okay. So we'll just grab some glass. Okay, so how do we make it? There. Okay, so we'll just make 8 of these restricted Essentia tubes. We will also make 1 of this just to get the EMC and the directional. All right, that's not going to be it. How do you do that? Okay, so we'll take out the green. There we go. Just grab one of that and that. Okay, we need an Essentia filter. Essentia filter. And we'll pop that in there, put this back, pop that in there, get the filtered Essentia tube, and get the valve. Okay, so let's take a look. So we'll just pop that in there, pop that in there, pop that in there. Let's see. To make this, okay, we need Essentia filters and iron and brass. Okay. All right, we got iron. So we'll just need 2 of these. We need some filters. So we'll need 2 of these. Okay. So let's take a look. The alchemical construct. Okay. So, we'll just make another valve. All right. An alchemical construct. All right, so we got that. And that is going straight into our transmutation table. And let's see. Okay. That is a auxiliary venting port. Okay, where am I? Okay. So, auxiliary venting port. Okay. And let's go ahead, pop that in there. And let's make another one. And then we take these auxiliary venting ports and we put them to the side like this, so that it will reduce the viz that's generated, you know, reduce the flux that's generated from this. And then let's go ahead and place this jar here. Okay. Let's see. Oh, yes. We got some more alchemical stuff to do. The Essentia centrifuge. Let's go ahead and take a look at that. I often find myself with complex Essentia I have no real need for. I need to find a way to put all that unused Essentia to a practical use. The alchemical centrifuge is a wondrous invention that allows me to break Essentia to its component parts. When compound Essentia flows into the centrifuge from below, it will be slowly broken down into primal or compound Essentia that it's made from. Only one of the components is created for each point of Essentia broken down. The resulting Essentia needs to be drawn from the top of the centrifuge because it idiosyncrasies of the two pressure system. It would be best to connect an Essentia buffer to the top of the centrifuge. So, wow, okay. We got that. What the heck is this? Simple arcane mechanism. A simple arcane mechanism and a morphic resonator. Okay. So we need rare earths. Okay. Rare earths. Rare earths. And one more glass. Okay. So we'll just make that into panes. And what was that again? And brass. Okay. Oh, come on. All right. So we'll just put that in there. Take that. And take this and this and this and that. Okay. So we got the morphic resonator. We will pop that into here. Now, what was the other thing that was needed? A simple arcane mechanism. All right, let's go ahead and look up JEI because the book isn't telling us. A simple arcane mechanism. So that is a stick, an iron, and brass. Okay. So we'll just grab two of this, grab some brass, and grab some sticks. Okay. And pop. Okay. We got a simple arcane mechanism. So we'll just pop that in there. And what else did it need? Needed Essentia tubes and an alchemical construct. Okay, so tube. It needed two Essentia tubes and an alchemical construct. Okay, now, then it was a centrifuge. Centrifuge. It's this doohickey right here. There we go. What does that do? Okay. Let's place it down and figure out what it does. Okay, I am going to have to look into how this works. Because I'm feeling that it needs more assembly. It needs more to assemble it. But at least we can get the Thaumium Essentia Smelter. This is what I want. Alright, the basic Essentia Smelter is quite crude, if I have to be honest with myself. It is extremely inefficient and rather slow. I chalk this up to the low quality of materials it is crafted from. I believe Thaumium could prove more useful in improving the smelting process. I should run some experiments to see how effective it would be at containing Essentia slurry. I should probably improve the plumbing inside the smelter itself. So, we need to do research for one in alchemy. So let's go ahead and click on the crucible. And if you notice, we got more light bulbs, more ideas. So you can see that this is improving over time. So let's take a look. All right, so this one is 25 alchemy. This one is 40 alchemy. Spiritus Invictus. I think we may already have that. So let's take a look. That is Dreadia, that is Victus, and Spiritus. Where is Spiritus? Spiritus. Still looking. Just so much to sort through. Okay, Spiritus. Okay, so while I'm at it, pop that in there. Where did I put the rest? Oh yeah, I just dumped it in here. Okay, so let's see. Victus and Spiritus. All right, and let's hit Control O to get rid of JEI. Okay, so we need some alchemy to gain 15 alchemy and a bonus draw. Okay, so let's take a look at what we got. All right, now what's this? We got Humanus, all right? Alchemy, I just saw it. Here it is, alchemy. Okay. So let's go ahead and click on Alchema. Okay, Spellbinding, Sculpting, Daylight Sensor or Clay. Let's just do Clay. Okay, one Clay. All right, so we got a little bit in Golemancy. Measure. All right, this one is for infusion, that is artifice, and that is infusion. Let's just do a little infusion. Okay, okay, this is alchemy, this is Spiritus and Perditio. Okay, so we'll grab a little bit more Spiritus, which is right here, and Perditio right there. Go ahead and put this back. All right. And yoink. What did we get? We got Adversio. Okay. Measure. Potentia Essentia. Okay. So let's go ahead and grab a file. A glass file. And Potentia. Potentia. Is there enough here? No. There is not. But you know what? I am not worried about it. We will get to it later. So let's go ahead and do something else. Measure. All right. And then let's take a look. Experimental transfusion. Exium, we do not have it, but let's rethink. Alright, calibrate. Celestial studies, waning crescent. Do we have waning crescent? I think so. Do we have waning crescent? No, we don't. Okay. I'm still working on collecting those observations. So we'll go ahead and do some Golemancy. And concentrate. Alright, that one is alchemy. That's what we want. So we needed Motus. Okay, there we go. Motus. That's Volatus. That's Ordo. It's Potentia. Motus. Okay. Alright, inspired. Gain 59 alchemy. Yes, please. And we got our point in alchemy. Woo! Okay, let's take a look. And we need a thaumium plate. Okay. A thaumium plate. Alright, we'll just need 3 of these. Alright, let's go into our crafting table. Grab some of that. Teach our system how to make it. And finish up with that. Okay. Thaumium has proven to be a good choice, though not quite as effective as I hoped. The thaumium smeltery works like a basic smeltery, but it has roughly 85% efficiency instead of 80. Not nearly the improvement I was hoping for, but better than nothing, I suppose. Its main benefit is that it breaks down Essentia slurry at double the normal speed. So we're going to need the Essentia smeltery, we're going to need an alchemical construct, 5 plates, and 2 brass plates. So let's go ahead and grab this. We're going to need brass. We're going to need 2 of these. And then we're going to need some thaumium. And we're going to need 3 more of these. Alright, this will be our last crafting before wrapping up for today. Okay, so we'll go ahead and grab this. And the thaumium smeltery. So let's go ahead and hit Control O, and the thaumium smeltery. Okay, the thaumium Essentia smeltery. Boom! We just improved our smeltery. So there's one more thing that I want to do, and that is to make the arcane bellows. So how do we make arcane bellows? So let's see. So let's take a look. All right, the arcane bellows. That's easy. Okay, so we need some wood. So we need 2 wood, 4 leather. And 1 iron. Okay. Come on. All right. And then, we need 2 more wood. All right. And then, that should do it. And the arcane bellows will make it burn hotter. So if we place it like that, no, not quite how you do it. You place it like that. Nope. Okay, if you place it down, where does it push? I need it to be facing the other way. Okay. Yeah, it's not attaching. You'd think that this would attach to something. Oh well, we will deal with that another time. Anyway, I am out of time for this episode, but we did improve our smeltery. We upgraded to Thaumium and we got some of the Essentia smelted, and we actually got the Essentia centrifuge. I'm going to do a little homework to find out how do you set up the Essentia centrifuge in a little bit. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed yourself this episode, and be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share. This has been Whisperfire, and I wish you an awesome day. Oh yeah.